Hello friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So this is the morning tales for January 7, 2021 and let's begin this video without wasting any time. So here this is our YouTube channel and I would like those users who are coming for the first time to subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. So now we are on our first question. So the first question is, which of the following institution has launched virtual Agri Hackathon 2020 in association with Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Family Welfare? So first of all, the most important or unique thing about this hackathon is that it is the first of its kind initiative that has been inaugurated, or we can say launched, in the agriculture sector. So it is the largest ever virtual event in the Indian agriculture sector. So therefore it is an important initiative, or we can say it is an important event. So this Agri Hackathon has been launched in order to innovate and come up with the solutions in the agriculture sector of India. So in order to have innovative solutions in the agriculture sector, this hackathon has been launched. Now it has been launched by this Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Family Welfare, which is under the Ministry of Agriculture and Family Welfare, in association with an institution from the options. So what is the right answer? It is option A, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, PUSA. So it is the institute with which this department has collaborated to launch this hackathon. Now guys, if it is a hackathon, so there would be a prize also. So the winners, the top 24 winners will get ₹1 lakh as prize. And the winning solutions or the innovative ideas that will get the award or that will win this hackathon will get 5 lakh as the pre-seed funding and ₹25 lakhs as the seed stage funding. Now guys, these two things, pre-seed and seed stage fundings, are the investment stages of a startup. So at different stages, the different amounts will be paid to the innovative solution. So that's all for this question from this virtual Agri Hackathon 2020. Now my question from you is that you have to tell me the Minister of Agriculture and Family Welfare. Now we are on our next question. So who heads the South Asia Group for Energy? First of all guys, I would like to tell you that this is an important question. There are high chances that this question can be asked in the examination. So do listen to me very carefully. Recently, the central government has formed this South Asia Group for Energy in order to strengthen the energy architecture in the South Asian region. You must have heard about the One Sun, One World, One Grid slogan, or we can say motto, of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So what is this thing, One Sun, One World, One Grid? This is basically an idea given by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to have a central grid to share the solar energy among different countries. And India aims to become the nodal country of this central grid. So in order to strengthen this electricity, or we can say the energy trading system in the South Asian region, this group has been formed, which will suggest the capacity building measures, as well as this group will also facilitate a dialogue, or we can say it will also facilitate a platform for communication between the countries regarding this solar grid or energy trade. And now the question is that who is the person that is going to head this group? So the person is option C, Ram Vinay Shahi. So Ram Vinay Shahi was the former power secretary, basically he was the secretary in the Ministry of Power earlier. Now he has become the head of this South Asia Energy Group, which is short formed as SAGE. So do remember this thing, that this is the Indian government that has formed this group, and the head is Ram Dinesh Shahi, and the purpose is to strengthen the electricity, or I would say the energy trading architecture of the South Asian region. So that's all for this question. Now I'm going to move to the third question. With which organization has J&K IT Infrastructure Development Company signed an MOU for developing IT infrastructure in Jammu and Kashmir? So first of all, this IT stands for Information Technology, and recently this company has signed an MOU with a company from the options. And guys, let me tell you here that there are not many facts related to this question. It is a very simple news that an MOU has been signed between this company and this National Building Construction Corporation. Now you would be a little amazed ki Construction Corporation is the company with which this J&K IT Infrastructure Company has partnered to develop the IT infrastructure of the Union Territory. So it is a little anomaly that this building construction company is going to develop the infrastructure technology, this information technology infrastructure in the J&K. But yes, it is the reality. Both these organizations have collaborated for this purpose. Now guys, the information ends here, because as I told you earlier that there are not many facts. But my question from you is a very significant question, and that is the Lieutenant Journal of J&K. So this is your task that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Not Lieutenant Journal, it's the Governor. So you have to tell me the Governor of J&K in the comment section below. Now we are at our next question. So when was the Pune Meteorological Observatory established? So basically this Pune Meteorological Observatory, why is it in the news? I will tell you this thing a little later, but let me tell you the answer of this question, that in which year was it established. So it was established in the year 1867. Now why is it in the news? The reason behind this is that World Meteorological Organization has recognized this observatory as Centennial Observing Station. So this award, this recognition has been given by WMO to this PMO is because of its performance during the 100 years of its establishment. So basically, in order to honor the work that has been done by this observatory in the 100 years, this recognition has been given by World Meteorological Organization. Now guys, where this World Meteorological Organization is located, the headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland. And when was this observatory established, that we have already discussed. But the thing that we have not discussed till now is the director of this observatory. So this is your task that you have to tell me, that who is the director of this meteorological observatory. Now guys, we are talking about the meteorological observatories, therefore we should also talk about, or we can say we should also pay a little attention to the father of meteorological observatories in India. So which organization it is? It is Indian Meteorological Department. So when was that organization established? It was established in 1875. So this observatory is older than the IMD, but IMD is still the father of this organization, as well as the different meteorological observatories that are there in India. So do remember the IMD's year of establishment, as well as this Patna Meteorological Observatory's year of establishment. What is the new permissible limit of trans fatty acids levels in oils and fats by the year 2021? So recently, food safety and Standards Authority of India, FSSAI, has mandated that the trans fatty acids from the oil and fats should be kept at a level of 3% by the year 2021 and 2% by the year 2022. Now, what does this mean? What is the whole meaning of this thing? So, the simple meaning here is that the FSSAI has mandated all the oil and fatty acid manufacturing companies to keep the trans fatty acids level at the 3% by in the year 2021 and then reduce it to 2% by the year 2022. Now guys, you would be amazed to know this thing that WHO, World Health Organization, on the other hand, is calling for the total elimination of trans fatty acids by the year 2023. So do remember this thing that by the year 2023, WHO is calling for the total elimination of trans fatty acids, and India has set the target of keeping the trans fatty acids up to the level of 2% by the year 2022. And nothing has been said about the 2023, but most probably it would be the total elimination of trans fatty acids. But we cannot assume this thing, right? So we have to wait from the government side that what is going to happen in the future regarding this trans fatty acid thing. But for the time being, do remember this thing, 3% is for 2021 and 2% is for 2022. Now, why is it important? What is this thing, trans fatty acid? You must have heard about this trans fat acid. So this trans fat acids are the fatty acids that are created or that are there in every food that we eat, basically. But what is so dangerous about these trans fatty acids? The dangerous thing is the industrially produced trans fatty acids, which are unsaturated fat, and it harms the body. According to WHO, according to World Health Organization, around 5.4 lakh people each year die due to the intake of this trans fatty acid. So basically, due to the consumption of this industrially produced trans fatty acid, around 5.4 lakh people die in the world. Therefore, it is the urgent call from the WHO to eliminate the trans fatty acids by the year 2023. So that's all for this question, but my question for you is that who is the chair of FSSAI? And do remember this thing, I have discussed it earlier as well, and it is an important organization, therefore you have to mention it in the comment section below. Next question is, what is the name of marathon of focused sector specific webinars organized by the Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade in association with Quality Council of India, National Productivity Council and industry bodies? So let's first discuss the answer of this question, then I will try to decode this whole question for you. Now, what is the answer? Is it Udyog Parishad, Samrakshak, Sahakar, Udyog Manthan, Udyog Sahyog? So out of these five udyogs, the right answer is option D, Udyog Manthan. So Udyog Manthan is the series of webinars that is going to be organized by the Department of this Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade along with these two organizations and the industry bodies. Now, what is the purpose of creating this series of webinars? The purpose is just to brainstorm on the measures that can improve the quality and productivity of manufacturing and services in India. So as we know that the government, our ambitious government, is targeting to make India the manufacturing hub of the world, and if we are aiming to become the manufacturing hub, then quality and productivity are the two things that are inevitable for us to keep in our focus. Therefore, in order to keep those things in our mind and improve on productivity and quality, this series of webinars named as Udyog Manthan has been organized by this Department of Promotion. So do remember these things that I have told you here, and nothing so special about this webinar is there. Now we have our next question. Which of the following CSIR affiliated organization has developed Swasth Vayu ventilator? So here we know that the answer of this question is a CSIR affiliated organization. So do you know which organization is affiliated with CSIR from the options? If you know, then it is a good thing. But if you don't know, then let me tell you that all these three organizations are affiliated to CSIR, that is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. Now then, what is the answer of this question? So the answer is option D. Both A and B, that is National Aerospace Laboratories and Institute of Genomics and Integrative Biology. This first Vayu ventilator was created by these two organizations at the start of this pandemic in order to address the shortage of ventilators that we faced in the beginning of this pandemic. So why is it in the news right now in January 2021? So the reason behind this is in news is that recently a committee, an expert committee of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, has approved that this first Vayu ventilator can be used by the COVID-19 patients who need supplementary oxygen up to the level of 35%. So basically it has approved this first Vayu ventilator for the COVID-19 patients with 35% supplementation need. That's all for this question. That was only thing that was there in the news. Now guys, we have discussed everything related to this question, but my question from you is that you have to tell me the head of CSIR, who heads this Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. And our next question is, which country has announced to develop world's first wooden satellite by 2023? So it is again a new innovation towards the space sciences, and which country has announced it? It is the Japan. Japan has announced to launch, or we can say to create, the world's first wooden satellite. Now let me first tell you the companies that have collaborated for creating this satellite. So it is University. So these are the two Japanese organizations that have collaborated to create this world's first wooden satellite. Now guys, why are they creating wooden satellite when we already have so many metals and aluminium is the most prominent metal from which the satellites are created? Then why wooden satellite is required? The reason behind this is very logical from the Japanese government, that due to the aluminium satellites, or when the aluminium or whatever metal it is, when the satellites come back to the Earth's surface, majority of them get half burnt, and due to this their remaining debris float in the environment or in the atmosphere, which has a very high risk of falling on the Earth's surface. And as we know that many satellites, even the most, I would say, most bereaved countries are also launching their own satellites. Therefore, a huge number of satellites are there in the space, and more are in the pipeline to come. Therefore, in order to reduce the amount of debris in the environment, this wooden satellite is going to be created, which will completely burn in the atmosphere itself and do not leave any residues or any debris in the space. But if how much this satellite project is going to be successful, that is a thing of time. We have to wait and watch that ye satellite safal ho bhi paati hai ya nahi. So our next question is, what is India's GDP growth rate for FY22 according to World Bank's Global Economic Prospects January 2021 report? So it is the beginning of the GDP forecast, and this report has inaugurated the GDP forecast line for this year. So World Bank has released its Global Economic Prospects report for January 2021, and according to this report, India is going to achieve a growth rate of 5.4% in 2021 to 2022. What What is the contraction rate of India in 2020 to 2021? It is -9.6, so it is unchanged. It was the same that World Bank has announced earlier. And for 2021 to 2022, it is 5.4%. And for 2022 to 2023, the growth rate is 5.2%. For the world, the contraction rate is -4.3%. And the growth rate for 2021 to 2022 is 4%. So it is only for the year 2021 and 2022. So do remember these stats, these forecasts that are there in this report. This is an important report, guys. Do remember this thing that it is World Bank that releases the Global Economic Prospects Report. Next question is, which of the following company is the implementing agency of Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana Sehat Scheme of Central Government for J&K? So basically this Sehat Scheme has been recently launched by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi in J&K, UP. So this is the central scheme. This is basically a specific name given to the Ayushman Bharat Scheme that has been launched in J&K, UP. And what are the provisions of this scheme? All the provisions that are there in this Jan Arogya Yojana are there in Sehat Yojana as well. But the unique thing here is that it is the J&K UT in which this Sehat scheme has been launched. Now guys, which company is the implementing agency of this scheme in the J&K UT? So it is Bharat Bajaj Alliance General Insurance Company. So do remember this thing. It is an important question and it can be asked in the examination. Now, do you know that Sehat 2 has its full form? What is the full form of Sehat? It is Social Endeavor for Health and Telemedicine. So this is the full form of Sehat scheme. Do remember the implementing agency, that is Bajaj Alliance General Insurance Company. Now, who is the CMD of this company? Who is the chairman and managing director of this company? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. And here this session ends. I hope that you have gained fruitful knowledge from this session, and if you have, then do spread this knowledge among your friends and share this session and do like it. Thank you so much for watching this video.